Let's take a look at three ways you can transpose your data in Excel. The method one is static, two and three are dynamic. Let me know in the comments below which method you use. For me, method three has been my most used one so far. Here's our sample data set. We have a list of apps and their sales values. Method number one is the static methods. What I'm going to do is to highlight the area that I want transposed. I'm going to press Ctrl+C, go to the area where I want my result to sit in, right mouse click, paste special, put a check mark for transpose, click on OK. That's my data. Now the downside to this is it's not dynamic, this is static. So if something changes here, it's not going to pull through in here. Method number two is to use the transpose formula. And yes, there is a formula called transpose. It only needs one argument. So I'm just going to highlight this, close bracket, press enter. Doesn't work. If I click inside the formula bar and I click on F9 to see what's behind it, I can see my apps here, I can see my numbers here, but it can't put all of these results in one cell. And because transpose is an array formula, what I need to do is to highlight the areas of the cells that I want the results in before I write the formula. Now the tricky part is to highlight the area first, because let's say I'm not sure if it goes until here or here or here. Well, I can count, but I'm not patient enough to count this. I'm just going to highlight this, go to the formula bar, type in the same formula, close bracket. Now here's the important part. Don't press enter, press Ctrl, Shift, and then enter. Now we see our results in separate cells, which is great, but it gets cut up to here because I didn't select enough cells before. So what I'm going to do is to pull this further. It's until here, but notice the result is all messed up. That's because I need to go back to the formula bar and click Ctrl, Shift, Enter again. Okay, so now we can see it's corrected. Now, because it's a formula, everything I change here, it's going to pull through. So that's the advantage of using this function. Let's pause. The future dynamic arrays are going to make transposing data much easier. You don't have to worry about highlighting the result area first before writing your formula. Now you also don't have to worry about pressing Ctrl Shift Enter because the formula is going to spill by default. I already posted a video on dynamic arrays. It shows you the potential of what it can do. Check the link in the description. So let's move on to method number three. The aim is to have simple cell references. I want this to equal this. And then I want this to equal this one. But the problem is that I can't pull this way, because when I do, it actually moves this way, right? It's not moving down. And I could go through each one and type the formula in, but that's going to be super annoying, right? So instead, what I'm going to do is to type the formula in the cell as text. So instead of typing in the equal sign, I'm going to put A3. And then here I'm going to put A4 and so on. But I'm not going to do this manually. I'm going to use Excel's fill options to help me do that. One other thing I'm going to do is to add a prefix to this cell reference. I'm going to use my initials LG. And you're going to see why in a second. So I'm going to put LG A3 here and LG B3 here, right? So that's supposed to be this cell. Now I'm going to highlight this and pull this over. Now notice what's happening here. It says LG B12, B14. The numbers after the initials are moving in the right direction. Control H. I'm going to look for LG and I'm going to replace it with the equal sign. I get my formulas in there. And they're simple formulas, but it's much faster than going to each cell and typing in the reference to the correct cell, especially if you have a lot of columns and a lot of data. Now, also let me know in the comments below what your favorite transpose method is. Give the video a thumbs up if you liked it, and subscribe to this channel if you want to learn more about Excel.